Hello, my name is Richard Gallagher, and I'm President and CEO of Xytech. I'd like to demonstrate our new web interface, Sky, which we are all very proud of. I think you'll find it revolutionary and a pleasure to work with. Sky has a unique user interface approach that is comprised of multiple dashboards with multiple panels that are easily configurable by the user or administrator. Sky leverages almost all the vast capabilities in our smart client user interface, including layouts and reports. Layouts may be configured for just Sky, just a smart client, or the layout may be used for both interfaces. Dashboards are easily configurable for your end user or your customer's portal. Sky works from your browser at home, on your iPad or Android, and from our cloud. Let's get started with the demonstration. I'm going to go ahead and sign into Sky. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to make it full screen by clicking this icon right here. On the left side, I have my favorites. I have multiple dashboards and my modules. Within each module, I can expand and collapse to see all the programs within that module. Down at the bottom, I have my recent documents and recent reports, so I can rerun anything that I've done in prior sessions. So let's go ahead and call up a dashboard. So I'm going to call up my dashboard. This could be set up to come up initially when I log in. I chose not to do that at this point. Okay, so over on the upper left here, I have my jobs. On the bottom left, I have my contacts. And on the right here, I have my quick time card. I can go in and look at a certain job's record. So if I go to job number 300, it's going to go ahead and it's going to call it up over here on the right side. So this layout is the exact same layout that can appear in the smart client. So we have our custom fields. So all the custom fields are supported. These are the work orders for the job. I can click and drill down to a work order. Here's the totals for the job. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and close out of this. Okay, we have a gadget here to go ahead and search for our library. So if I want to search for the word hunt in any field and the file is a QuickTime file, I can go ahead and do that and it calls up my list right here. Now if I want this to be bigger, I have a couple options here. I can go ahead and move this to a new dashboard, or I can just make it full screen. So that entire panel is now full screen, and here's all the QuickTime assets that have the word hunt somewhere in there. Okay, now I can multi-select assets here, call a quick service, which automatically might transcode, might watermark in QC, and send it to a location, right, depending on the quick services that I have set up. All right, so let me go ahead and exit out of full screen here. And then the other thing that can be done here is this navigator can be set to not show up. Okay, so sites that maybe clients as a customer web portal, you don't want them to pick any other options, so you can set up their dashboards for them and it just comes up here and shows them what they're allowed to do. So scheduling dashboard can have multiple views. Here's a graphics view, here's a rooms and editor view. These are completely configurable. Let's go to graphics view. Let's go back in time a little bit. Let's go back to April. Go back to the beginning of April. And here's a list of our bookings. Now we can zoom out here. There's lots of levels of zoom. There's a calendar view option by clicking this icon. I can select one or more resources and I can get their schedule appearing right here on the view. Okay, let's get out of calendar mode. And let's go ahead and add a new booking. So I can take this timeline and scroll it, and I can go and add a booking wherever I want. So if I want to add a booking right here, I can just drag, add a booking, put a name for my booking, let's say Sky Demo. Let's say it's a very important demo, so I'll make it VIP. I could create an order or just save the booking here and hit save. Now I can take this booking if I wanted to and drag it to another day, or I could drag it to another person or room, hit save. And it's done. Okay, let's go ahead and look at some other dashboards. So I'm going to close the scheduling dashboard and let's go and look at my charts. All right, so it's very easy to write charts and you can create charts on almost anything. Here's a list of purchase orders by purchase order type that are open. Here's a list of work orders by dollar amount, by month, by account rep. Here's a list of active jobs by account rep. And here's a total of suspended tasks. So we can see that we've got a lot of them. We need to go ahead and tend to those. So let's go ahead and get out of my charts and let's look at the My Widgets dashboard. It's very easy to create this. You can just go to the web, go to a free widget, you just copy and paste into here, and it's easy as that. So here's a YouTube videos, here's a currency converter, stock quotes, again, whatever you want. It's probably out there for a widget. And here's a list of jobs. Okay, let's go ahead and create a dashboard from scratch and see how easy it is to do that. Okay, so if I want to, let's say, place my contacts up here, I want to have a list of jobs show down here. Okay, it has my default view. I could change my criteria. When I save my dashboard, it saves my criteria. And let's say I also want to create a chart. So I'm going to go here and create a chart. Let's say I want a pie chart. My data source is work orders. And I'm going to call it confirmed work orders. And I'm going to do account, but I'm going to do a work order total by account rep. Okay, now it's asking me how I want to filter. So I want to filter by phase is equal to confirmed. Save. All right, it's easy as that. Now I can take this and let's say I want to put that over here. You know, maybe you want to change the width of this guy over here, you know, and I could also change the width of these guys over here. And I can create more and split these and so forth. And to save the dashboard, I just go here and hit Save Dashboard. And that's it. Sky supports the extensive MediaPulse security. It's fully internationalized. It supports multiple themes and support for custom branding.